为什么说错知有修行的比丘存在是无明呢？因为若禅修者根据佛陀的教导而分析内外的身心，他会发现只有究竟明色法存在而已。若他如实地了知那些只是明色法，这种见解是正确的，是观智，是正见。但是若他认为有真实的男人、女人、比丘、比丘尼存在，这种见解则是错误的，是无明。由于无明，所以他发愿成为修行的比丘，这就是爱。他执着修行比丘的生命，这就是取。无明、爱、取这三项称为烦恼轮转，他们是生死轮回的根本。
Altogether, there were five past causes: ignorance, avijja, craving, tanha, clinging, upadana, pollution and formation, sankhara, and karma.
因此，总共有五种主因，也就是无明、爱、取、行、业。
Then he descends the five aggregates at the rebirth linking moment, Padishandi.In his present life, at that moment, there were 30 types of materiality. They arose as 3 types of kalabas, namely the body digate kalaba, self vigasa, and heart digate kalaba. In each type of kalaba, there were 10 types of materiality. Then he descended back and forth between those 30 types of materiality and the 5 past causes.Ignorance, craving, clinging, pollution and formations, and karma. He put special emphasis on the force of karma to check whether it produced those 30 types of materiality. He checked this again and again and was able to see that it did. This is the example of a meditator.
然后他必须关照今世投生时结生心刹那的五蕴，结生心时有30种业生色法存在，这些业生色法存在三种色聚当中，也就是生识法聚、性根识法聚以及心色识法聚，它们各含有10种色法。能观照这三十种业生色法之后，必须再度关照无明、爱、取、行、业这五种过去因，尤其要注重关照业力，反复地关照前世临死时成熟的业力与今世结生时的30种业生色法，以便检查那些色法是否由前世那个业力所产生。
If you practice in this way, you can easily understand that the force of karma accumulated in your past life produced the materiality aggregate at your rebirth linking moment. How? At that time, you should have already understood how does the consciousness arising dependent on the heart base produces mind-produced materiality, and have already know their causal relationship.In the same way, there is a causal relationship between the force of karma and karma-produced materiality. If you see the causal relationship, you should discern that because of the arising of ignorance, craving, clinging, pollution and formations, and karma, materiality arose at the rebirth linking moment.
如何观缘起因果关系呢？在这个阶段，禅修者已经能观察到依靠心所依处而升起的心如何产生许多心生色聚，也就是了知心与心生色法之间的因果关系。正如心产生心生
The object of
业力能产生业生色法，他应当来回地关照前世临死时成熟的那个业力 与今世结生时的业生色法，以便检查今世的业生色法是否由前世那个业力所产生。确定之后，应当进一步如此观照，由于前世的无明爱取行业生起，所以今世结生时的业生色生起。
Then you should also discern the causal relationship between the force of karma in your past life and the present life mentality at the rebirth linking moment. Then you should discern the causal relationship between the force of karma and the resultant aggregates throughout your present life. Especially, you should emphasize the six two thought processes. You discern that because of the rising of ignorance,craving, clinging, volitional formations, and karma, the aggregate of materiality arises. Ignorance, craving, clinging, volitional formations, and karma are the causes, and the aggregate of materiality is the effect. This is the discerning of formations. The insight discerning this is the knowledge of discerning cause and condition.
接着也必须观照前世的业力与今世结生时的明法之间的因果关系，然后必须观照前世的业力与今世这一生中所有果报五蕴之间的因果关系，尤其注重于观照六门心路过程的果报五蕴。如果能观照由于前世的无明爱取行业升起，所以今世的果报色蕴等升起。前世的无明爱取行业是因，今世的果报色蕴等是果，这是观照行法的因缘生。如此观照的智慧是缘色受智，或者因缘生智见。因缘生智见，意思就是照见诸法因缘生的智慧。
Having taught the discernment of causal arising of formations, the Buddha taught, or he advised contemplating the passing away phenomena in the body. This means that you should also discern right the mindless cessation of the five causes.The five aggregates is completely without remainder. This is Vichyato Vaya Dasana Jnana. The inside knowledge that sees the remainderless cessation of causes in effects.
教导观照行法的因缘生之后，接着佛陀开示说，安住于观照生的坏灭现象，意思是他必须观照由于因缘灭尽无余，所以五蕴灭尽无余，这是因缘灭自见。
When will the five predominant causes, ignorance, craving, clinging, volitional formations, and karma, cease completely without remainder? According to the Buddha's teaching, the defilements will cease completely without remainder,When you enter hardship, because of the remainderless cessation of defilements, karma cannot produce any results after pranibbana. Your arahanta path will completely destroy the five causes without remainder. Because of the remainderless cessation of the five causes, after pranibbana, all five aggregates will cease completely without remainder.You must try to see this cessation because the Buddha instructs in the Mahasri Prana Sutta that he advised contemplating the passing away phenomena in the body. You should not forget that here the body means the body of materiality, Rupa Gaya, and the body of mentality.
造成轮回的五种主因，无明、爱、取行业何时才会灭尽无余呢？根据佛陀的教导，烦恼会在你证悟阿罗汉道的时候灭尽无余， 由于烦恼灭尽无余，所以之后业力就不再能产生任何果报。阿罗汉道彻底无余地灭除五种因，由于五种因灭尽无余，所以薄涅槃后五蕴会灭尽无余。应当照见这种灭，因为佛陀在大念处经中开示说，他安住于观照身的坏灭现象。别忘了这里的身是指色身与名身而言。
Now you are not Arhats yet. When will you attain Arhatship? Will it be in the present life or in the future life? Suddenly it will be in the future. How so? If you break this heart and if you have enough Barmi, you may attain Arhatship in this very life.Even then, it is also called the future from the view of momentary rising and passing away. If you will attain Arhatship in the coming future life, it is your future. When you attain Arhatship, all the five causes will completely cease without Omega. You should try to see this cessation. And again,When you take Pranibbana, all the five aggregates will completely cease without Maida. You must try to see this cessation too. If you see these two types of cessation, you should contemplate that. Because of the Maida-less cessation of the five causes, the five aggregates also completely cease without Maida. This type of inside knowledge is called Vayada Udiyavaya Dasana Jnana.The inside knowledge that sees the remainderless cessation of causes in their effect.
现在你还不是阿罗汉，你会在什么时候证悟阿罗汉道呢？是现在还是未来呢？当然是未来。多久的未来呢？如果你具备充分的波罗蜜，而且持续精进的修行，你就可能在今生证悟阿罗汉道。即使在今生证悟，然而从刹那生灭的角度来看，那时对现在而言也称为未来。如果你将在来生证悟阿罗汉道，那么来生也是你的未来。在你证悟阿罗汉道的那个未来时候，无名、爱、取、行、业这五种因会灭尽无余，由于这五种因灭尽无余，所以薄涅槃时五蕴灭尽无余。你必须照见这两种灭，这种观智称为因缘灭智见，也就是能够照见因灭与果灭的智慧。
So if you want to know the causal relationship between causes and cause and effect, obligation, right inside knowledge, you should discern the past, present and future materiality and mentality. Do you think that in the Mahasri Prana Sutta, the Buddha taught only about the present? If you understand the meaning of the Buddha's teaching, you will not think so. Prana describes.Present and future materiality and mentality are to be discerned with inside knowledge. They are the objects of inside knowledge. Without discerning the past, present and future materiality and mentality, you cannot understand the principle of dependent origination. If you do not understand it, you cannot escape from the round of rebirth.You cannot discern the rising and passing away of causes and effects. You cannot contemplate both causes and effects as impermanent, suffering and non-self. If you cannot do so, escape from the round of rebirth because the Buddha mentions so in the Mahanidhana Sutta.
如果想以观智直接了知因果关系，你就必须先能观照过去、现在与未来的名色法，否则就无法见到的灭尽无余。讲到这里， 我们还能说佛陀在大念处经当中只教导观照现在的名色法而已吗？如果了解佛陀的教导，我们就不会那样说。过去、现在、未来的名色法都必须观照，因为它们都是观智的目标。如果不观照过去、现在、未来的名色法，就无法了知缘起法，也无法观照因果的生灭为无常、苦、无我，如此就不能解脱生死轮回。
Today, let us stop here. We will continue the questions and answers.
今天开始就到这边告一个段落，接着禅师要回答问题。